Hey guys, Scott here from Chernobyl Studios, and you may notice things are a little bit different. There's a different angle. You can see I got a little bit of a new desk here. A lot of things have happened in the last couple of weeks. I got a lot of things going on. But in this video, I want to dive into TrveCab, because TrveCab, other than having a true name, is a fantastic cabinet impulse response loader that does something different. And that is very important in this day and age when there are a lot of cab IR loaders, which is fine. But TrveCab is really setting itself apart, which means that the impulses that come with TrveCab, they're going to want to use these particular impulses, and I'll tell you why in just a second. But there are a bunch of impulse response loaders here, and we're going to go over the actual TrveCab impulse response loader, plus a couple of the IR packs. For example, Old School Black Metal. We'll go over the U.S. Death Metal. We'll go over USA Thrash Metal, and then Texas Metal, all right? You're going to love it, okay? So let's go ahead and open up Cubase here. So what I have done for this particular session, to really showcase the type of tones that you can get, they're not in the mix, and I'm going to show you basically one or two little EQ moves that you could make. But the main thing is I'm going to use the same exact amp for all of the different cabinet impulses, because as you guys know, cabinet impulses make or break the tone. And if you have something called like the Texas Metal Pack, well, it better have a particular tone that you're looking for, right? So we're really going to put these tones to the test. We're really going to understand, okay, if I get the Black Metal Impulse Response Pack, am I going to get a black metal sound? That's what we're going to find out. All right, so for this series, I am going to use the Nimbrini Audio. This is the version 2 of the MRH810. It's right here, version 2. And in most cases, I'm just using the Green Screamer here. But when it came to the death metal tone, because we're going to do a Cannibal Corpse style, I used a Metal Zone pedal, which is what they did back in the day. All right, so let's go ahead and just jump right into the first tone here, which is the Old School Black Metal tone. Let's have a listen and talk about what we did. All right, so you may know that song. That's a very famous Emperor song, Cosmic Keys to My Creations and Times. It's not the exact riff. These are more or less done by ear, so I'm sorry if they're not 100% correct. So here's TrveCab. Now, one of the first things that I would like to ask the guys over at TrveCab is that please, when you close the plugin here, the navigation tree closes. So, for example, if I know that I want this particular preset and then I load the preset and then I close and I go on and do my stuff and I come back, I want to tweak something, I open it, it's closed. All right, this is a little bit of annoyance, but, you know, it really doesn't matter after you have tweaked the faders, which I have done here. But if you want to go back to the starting point and you don't remember what preset that you used, I think it'd be cool to at least keep the navigation tree open. Or maybe it is open or something happened with my particular install. Who knows? But I remember which one I started with. I obviously started with Black Wizard. And I started with the main preset here. And then I dialed in a different sound on my own. So another thing about TrveCab is it does not do stereo processing. So TrveCab is on every single track here. But it's actually kind of cool because for this video, I'll be able to solo this, go through the different presets, and then I can just copy back the old settings that I had. So let's make sure this is playing. Fantastic. All I'm gonna do now is I'm not doing anything to the cab, or excuse me, the amp simulator. I'm doing nothing. All right, we're just gonna look at the cabinet impulse responses. So let's start with the Black Wizard main preset. So, yeah, you can get a pretty old school black metal sound straight away with all these presets. I really like the Black Wizard one. This has that classic Emperor sound that I love very much. Now, all I did was I messed with the faders. And speaking of messing with the faders, let's talk about what sets these Cav Impulses apart from all of the other Cav Impulse Response loaders. And that is this bad boy right here. This is called the Tube Sizzle, all right? I asked Ron what the hell this was, and basically what they did was they took a head, right? And they ran a sine wave through it, and then they basically just plopped the microphone on there to capture what the tubes would sound like under load, essentially. I don't know the specifics of how they did that, but it's very interesting because it completely gives you that extra atmosphere and the extra tonal qualities that you don't get with a lot of other Kevin IRs in general. So if we have a listen to what the Tube Sizzle does by itself, you're really going to understand the added atmosphere and characters that you can add to your guitar tone. So in it of itself, it's kind of crappy sounding, but when you mold it into the guitar tone, like, let's bring all this down. We'll just start at zero on the center, all right, and bringing all the other faders here, see what sound we can get, and you'll hear how the Tube Sizzle adds character to the guitar sound. So with that Tube Sizzle, it's just the little last 5% of extra added character that really makes your tone sound unique and stand out. I'm not aware of any other Cav Impulse Response Loader that does something unique like this, so I really, really enjoy it. All right. Now, that said, the Cav Impulse Response has sung amazing, and if you want to just load up a preset and have an instant old school black metal sound, it's clearly obvious that the black metal impulses are going to do that for you. So let's just go ahead and bring this back in here, and then let's do that. And all right, so the final thing I want to mention about TrveCab is right now there is no master fader on the actual plugin. This is kind of annoying a little bit because it would be great to adjust the output after you have done your fader movements and stuff like that, because the TrveCab plugin right now stands at about minus 18 dB output, which is fine. Perfect amount of headroom. You're never going to clip. But it basically means that on your drum bus group, you're going to need to have a limiter, right? And that's what I've done here. And I have the limiter set to about minus 12 dB of gain to really crank it. Now, if we're looking at EQ moves, I'm using Gliss EQ because we'll talk about Gliss EQ later, but I'm basically doing two dynamic cuts. So I'm still keeping the rawness, but I'm just sort of taming those high-end frequencies a little bit, and then some high mids that we're just messing with a little bit right here. Really enjoy this plugin. Going to be a video about this soon. But I'd done nothing. All I did was load a preset, tweak the preset a little bit, and now I have a classic black metal tone. Sounds very close to Emperor, all right? Which it should, because they used JCM 800s as well back in the day. So, black metal, all right? Let's move along now to death metal. Now, death metal, same principle here. Let's have a listen. And we are going to do a classic Cannibal Corpse riff. We'll try to. I'm not the best guitar player in the world. You're just going to have to live with the mistakes that I make, okay? You'll find it in your heart to live with it. I trust. All right, let's have a listen. Yeah, I made it through that riff somehow. I basically did. But now, same plugin, different impulse response pack, completely different sound. And I don't know about you, anyone who has listened to any type of 90s death metal, we're pretty much right on point, right? Same thing here. Let's go ahead and just load the presets. I have to do this really quick. I forgot. Set this down the center. All right, let's go. Really getting into mid-scoop territory there. I really like how every single preset is drastically different from one another. So you can already pick a starting preset with what the idea of the tone that you're going for. Like, I want to have low end in my guitar tone. I don't want to have it completely scooped. So I'm not going to go with the Tomb of the Mummified tone here. I really like Cockademon and Despise the Catatonia the most. I'm going to go with Cockademon because the lows and Despise the Catatonia are a little bit pumpy for me. So the same thing as last time. What did I do last time? I loaded the preset. I was like, wow, this is cool. It's already close to what I like. I just basically zeroed everything out here and then brought it all in with the mix. So here we have a couple of extra microphones. We have a center, we have a side, okay, and an edge, right? Plus a room and a tube sizzle. So we have more tonal qualities here. And again, I really believe that TrveCab, when you use the impulses from when you use the TrveCab impulse loader, you really do need to use the impulses that they've created, because you're not going to get these sounds, in my opinion, just by throwing in random third-party impulses. It works as a loader, of course. It'll be just fine. But you're really just missing out on the utility of this plugin if you're using somebody else's impulse responses. So that's why I really believe that TrveCab is unique, in that you want a particular era or a different sound, you go for TrveCab and you get the impulse pack that you're looking for, because you can still shape the sound, as I'm going to show you right here. So let's press play. There we go. So we have a completely unique sound just by moving the faders, the impulses that already exist. Now we'll get rid of this now. Let's bring in the old settings here. For the EQ, it's really kind of a lot of the same. Taming the high ends a little bit and then notching one little resonance that I didn't like, but not doing a lot at all. So really retaining the tonal characters of the guitar tone, really enjoying this EQ for that. Same thing with the bus limiter here, bumping up the sound, right? So we've already discussed why we're doing that. Pretty cool, huh? So we had black metal impulse response pack, now a death metal impulse response pack, and they both sound completely different from each other. So here is where the, you know, rubber meets the road, guys. Everyone says, hey, in order to get that Pantera tone, you need A, B, C, X, Y, Z, and then Dimebag's hands. That might be true, but you can get pretty damn close with this impulse response pack, okay? And again, I'm not doing anything different here. I have the same exact amp simulator, all right? And anyone who has listened to old school Pantera is going to be impressed by this. Let's go ahead and have a listen. That pretty much sounds very similar to vintage Cowboys from Hell. And I'm not using a Randall amplifier. I'm using a JCM 800, okay? Everyone knows that Dimebag used it. I believe it's the Randall 100 on the Cowboys from Hell. And it's a very unique tone. And all I did was I plopped a preset in here. All right, Texas Metal Cowboy. I adjusted the faders a little bit to what I like. All right, and let's bring this down to center here. I mean, it's not exact, but if there was anything that could bring you close to Dimebag's tone with a preset, it's the first time in my life that I'm going to say these are the Captain Impulses that can do that for you. Obviously, we have different eras of Pantera here. And I really have to say, amazing job. I really don't have any other words to say here. I don't know what else I could say, but this is fantastic. I really, really like the Texas Metal Pack. Very impressed with it. So, I mean, let's just... Super impressive, guys, for real. Let's go ahead and get the original cab settings back. Put this over here. Really, I don't have anything else to say about the Texas Metal Pack other than you need it. Very awesome. So if you have any inclination to try and do a Dimebag cover or a tone and you want to get a tone cover or a song and you want to get a tone pretty close to it, this is your answer right here. All right. Now finally, we have come upon the Thrash Metal Pack. Let's have a listen. I mean, what do you got to say? It's Slayer, right? And again, what do you got to say? Sounds awesome. Right away, the preset sounds amazing. Let's go ahead and have a look to some of the other ones. A listen, I should say. All right, just going to jump right through all the presets like last time. Blood Rain, for me, I like it the most. It has a starting point that I like the most. And the interesting thing about this one, too, is look how much tube sizzle is used on this one, right? Edge, Rear Room, and a truckload of tube sizzle. See if we can mess around with that a little bit. That's so fascinating because the tone doesn't pop out until you start bringing the tube sizzle into the mix. It's so fascinating. I really love that. And you wouldn't think that this would be the magic fader, right, where you need to pay attention to the tube sizzle and what it's doing. But it really is. It really, the tone doesn't pop out until that tube sizzle happens, and I really, really like it. I'm very impressed with these impulse response packs in general. I really believe that you need to have TrveCab in your arsenal. Let's unsolo that. It's incredible. Yeah, it sounds amazing. I highly recommend. So I just went over four packs, right? And what was the point of this video? To use the same plugins, the same amp simulator, which I've done here. You can see it's all the same, all the MRH, right? This exact same plugin. And we really wanted to put the impulses to the test, right? No studio magic, no mixing, not tucked away behind a bass guitar to sound thick and full and awesome. Just the impulses, right? So as it says on the website, you want to have old school black metal, you grab this impulse pack and you will get an old school black metal sound. Same for death metal, same for thrash metal, absolutely true for Texas metal. I had to test that one for myself. I'm absolutely impressed. And for that reason, so they have the Summer of Tone sale going on right now. TrveCab Impulse Response Bundle for $50. Geez, super affordable. There's no reason not to grab this. So I'm going to have a link to this bundle down below in the description. Full disclosure, it is an affiliate link. So if you pick it up from the link below, you'll be supporting not only myself, but also Ugritone. So it's a win-win situation. So please go ahead and click the link below. Support people that you like. Support the companies that you like that create the products that you like. So that's the only way to do it, especially during a time like now where things are a bit up in the air due to the global situation. So there is no doubt in my mind that you will find something in these impulse packs that will get you to where you want to go. So it's the first time in my life where I'm pretty much going to wholeheartedly say, hey, these are good presets. They do what the box says. And I think you should have them and tweak them to your heart's content. All right, guys, that's going to do it for me. I really hope you enjoyed the video. Please hit the subscribe button, hit like, hit that bell notification, leave a comment. Tell me what you thought of that Texas Metal cabinet impulse responses. That I'm still blown away by those. So tell me what you thought of those. And if you've used TrveCab or any of the impulse responses before, let me know what you think of them in the comments below. I'm very curious to hear about your experience with them. All right, so thanks a lot for watching the video, guys. I will talk to you in the next one. Have a good one.